great wonders of ice melt. The continent sinks slowly but steadily. Global warming is causing the large cities of the world to disappear into deep waters.
To tackle this problem of global warming, I, Sumit Saro of Class 12 of DB Public School Unit 8, am trying to create a model of a floating city that will be able to progressively develop into a better city for the society that lives in it. That is to say that if there are multiple researchers, it can have different components that will have the research station. And similarly, it will be able to self-sustain itself while outsourcing different kinds of software development tools and different kinds of research projects.
The key to design is using triangular components as each section of the city, which can be separately connected to one another to maximize the surface area while allowing the city to expand according to the people who decide to live on it. The city that I have currently designed is a general representation of the proposed city and is subject to change and improvement. First and foremost, the residential sector for the people. Each step is one floor and the staircase design is opted to give open spaces on each floor. Secondly, we have a commercial sector with shopping malls. Next, we have an event hall for all kinds of special occasions and ceremonies of the people. The twin spiral towers here serve as vertical farms with maximum availability of sunlight and air due to the spiral design. The smallest structure is a floristerial for flowers and herbs. The three towering structures are the manufacturing units and the disc-shaped building is spacious for offices. Here is the administration office with a harbor that can be accessed by small to medium-sized ships. At the heart of the city lies the colossal windmill, about 200 meters tall, that serves as the power source pumping electricity through all sections. It has been designed with different wingspans to procure maximum energy at the different heights due to the difference in ocean winds and their variance according to the height at which they flow at. Some say it's impossible to walk on water, but humanity should dare to live on it.